So the main hook of this painting here is the light effect. It's the light hitting this white wall and it glowing, and then you got this dappled light on the ground as well. So a few videos ago, I asked if anybody would like to see me do a night scene and see how I handle making, you know, lights look like they're lit up. And I was thinking about doing that, but I felt it was just too obvious of an example. And I wanted to do something that was more subtle and something that we will see more often. And that's something like this. You know, it's daytime, but one particular thing in this scene, it looks like it's glowing or it's being lit up. And how do you create that effect in your painting? Now, I'm going to say right here at the beginning that the reason this effect is working really doesn't have much to do with how I'm painting the lit up section as much as how I paint everything around it. Let me show you a simplified example of what I'm talking about. You can see here in this example that the yellow dot is very bright and it stands out as being very bright. But that exact same colored yellow dot here doesn't look as bright. That's because it's not surrounded by dark values like this one is. See, your light is only going to be as light as the darks are around it. You can see when I put a picture of my painting in black and white that there are a lot of dark values in this painting. Even the bushes that are being directly hit by sunlight and are bright as well are still much darker than the white wall it's up against. I always say value does all the work and color gets all the credit. The same goes for here as well. Getting the values is so important that I want to do that right at the start of my painting. I want to block my painting out in big shapes of flat color. It's like if I was going to block it out using cutout paper. I want to simplify the scene, squint my eyes, and paint what I see. This is going to allow me to see all the values of my painting and make sure they're all working together to create this light effect before I develop the painting further with more detail. I'll be able to see right away if this light effect is going to work or not. Now, if you're unsure about this whole process that I'm talking about with simplifying and seeing big shapes of flat color, I've actually made a whole video about this. I'll put a link to where you can watch that right here. So once I've blocked out the big dark shapes, when I lay in my light shape for where I want it to look like the sun is hitting it, it's going to work out perfectly. Now, I'm not using pure white here. I very rarely, if almost never, use pure white. I am adding a little bit of yellow and a tad bit of red into here. And once I lay it in, boom, it's working exactly how I want it to. If your painting isn't reading how you want to at this level, that means that you need to go back in and adjust your values. It's no big deal at this point, but if you start developing your painting more and more from here, and you get further down the road in your painting, you realize like, oh, all my values are off, my light's not looking bright, it's going to be a lot more difficult to change things up. So make sure it's working here and fix it here while it's easy. Also, a side tip, when it comes to painting something very bright, look to use a lot thicker paint in these sections. When you use thicker paint, you can even put it on with a palette knife if you want to. When you use thicker paint that's just raised off of the canvas a little bit, it's going to push the value to a level you just can't get with thinner paint. Just in general, you like to keep your darks and your shadows thin and your lights thick. You don't have to do this, it's just another tool that you can use to create an effect. Now, as I move on with the painting, I am going to add in other lighter values around my bright light effect, but I want to make sure that I don't make them too bright. I'm constantly stepping back and taking in the painting as a whole. I'm constantly moving around the painting and considering the big picture and the value relationships. Last thing I want to do is put too much lights in and totally kill my effect. Again, value does all the work, but color gets all the credit. And don't worry, the more you practice painting, the better you're going to get handling values, and the more you're going to be able to play with them and manipulate them and dial them in just exactly where you want. Helpful tip is while you're working, you can take a picture of your painting on your phone and put it in black and white, and it'll be a lot easier to gauge the values there. Now, for the light on the ground, I'm not going to make it as bright as the light on the wall. That's because this isn't getting hit as direct with sunlight as the wall is. Also, I want to keep that wall the focal point, but this ground is still going to be pretty bright. So I'm going to start out by putting a really warm pink base layer, knowing that I'm going to go on top of that with thicker, lighter paint as I go. Now, I noticed that the ground needs to be lighter, and it's actually getting a lot of reflected light from the sky, so it's this light, cool blue light. So I'm going to work some of that in there, but being careful not to push it too bright. If I push this light blue too much when I go in for the areas where light is hitting it, it's just not going to seem lit up because it's already next to another light value. Okay, when it comes to painting dappled light on the ground like this, there's two main things you need to be aware of. The first thing is that the brightest part of these little holes of light is going to be in the center. So I'm going to lay down this warmer pink first, knowing I'm going to come back in and put in a brighter spot in the center. The second thing you need to be aware of is that there's going to be a lot of soft edges dealing with this dappled light. That's because these light and shadows are being created by trees and leaves, which are always moving. You're not going to have very solid, rigid shadows. And having softer edges is going to help sell that effect. Now you can do this by running your brush over the edges or even using your finger like I did here and just softening and kind of blending in the light into dark values. This is pretty much like the only time I blend my paint. Like I've made a couple videos on how I don't blend my paint. I don't really consider this blending. I consider it softening an edge. So you want to soften your edges and then go back in with the lighter paint in the center. Also keep in mind the shape of these spots of light, and because of perspective, when they get further away from you on the ground, they're going to get thinner. So a spot of light that is close to you on the ground is going to be a lot thicker, and one that's further away from you, it's going to get a lot thinner. Also, don't get too uniformed with these. Last thing you want is a uniform pattern of light that just doesn't look natural. So always vary up the size and distance that you put these spots of light. So after that, I go in and develop the rest of the painting. All right, so let's review what we learned today. Number one, your light areas are only going to be as light as the darks around it. It's all about value relationships. Block in your scene first with big shapes of flat color that are easy to change and correct. Your light effect should be apparent at this stage. If not, fix it now while it's an easy fix. If you notice this later in the painting, it's going to be a lot more difficult to fix it. Look to paint dark areas with thinner paint and lighter areas with thicker paint. When it comes to dappled light, remember to use soft edges, and the lightest part is going to be in the center. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you can take what you've learned and implement it on your next painting and create some cool light effects. If you want to see the full tutorial of this painting, you can find it on my Patreon page, which is listed in the description below. Now, if you're really looking to improve your painting and get a strong foundation under you, I highly suggest my Foundations of Oil Painting course. It's 7 hours of content and is pretty much the course that I wish I had when I first started oil painting. The link to that is also in the description below. And if you want to see what I'm painting on a daily basis, you can follow me on Instagram at Forza43. I'm Chris Fornatero, here telling you to go get painting.